Let's move on to sorting algorithms. In a search algorithm, you have some kind of list and you're just checking out each element. However, in a sorting algorithm, you're changing the order of elements in an array. Let's say you wanted to sort these guys by height. You have some decisions to make first. Should I put the shortest element on this end or on this end? And what algorithm should I use to sort? You could just compare every element to every other element until you have everything in order. This is called the naive approach, since there's no real trick or cool algorithm involved there. The naive approach is normally the first thing your mind skips to when you see a new problem. It makes you think, I know I could do it this way and everything's going to be right, but there's probably a smarter way to do this. Sorting is kind of a weird topic. You'll rarely be given a problem that can't be solved with one of the classic sorting algorithms we go through here. As far as interviews are concerned, it's important to understand how sorting algorithms work and have their runtimes memorized so you can answer complexity problems really fast. Lastly, you should make sure you've considered whether your sorting algorithm is in place or not. An in-place sorting algorithm just rearranges the elements in the data structure they're already in, without needing to copy everything to a new data structure. These algorithms have low space complexity because you don't need to recreate the data structure. Often you'll have that classic trade-off when you use less space or use less time. It doesn't really matter for arrays with 10 numbers, but if you have millions or billions of data points, it makes a huge difference. It'll never hurt to mention that in an interview. You can pick one way over the other, but say while you're doing so. The more reasons you can provide for your choices, the smarter you seem.